The first anti-gravitational drone using magneto-hydrodynamic propulsion, or MHD, made its debut test flight in the desert around Edwards Air Force Base, where a number of prototypes came into being. The Belgians got a small glimpse of so-called UFOs in 1989 and 1990. The incriminating model was a triangular-shaped Astra TR-3B or XR-7, capable of flying in total silence at more than Mach 10. Now, I would like to speak to you about another concrete application of such technology. The B-2 bomber, whose development started in 1982. The official B-2 stealth bomber, which flew for the first time in 1989, was to serve as cover for another unconventional B-2 to be built in parallel. This top-secret model used, among other things, a plasma creation system, exploiting the airflow like an MHD generator. This system produces ionization of the air around the B-2, thereby suppressing air resistance while ensuring total invisibility for any type of radar. This nuclear bomber has flown for 15 years now at more than Mach 10. It can fly around the Earth in just a few hours without being seen. Naturally, such military research was to give rise to many commercial spin-offs. Over the last 10 years, we've seen the appearance of dozens of non-lethal armaments like E-bombs or electromagnetic bombs, as well as, of course, microwave weapons and powerful lasers. The US Department of Defense, through the multinational Raytheon, decided to invest a gigantic amount of money in an experimental program called HARP, or High Frequency Activate Auroral Research Program. And it was quite a program. Officially, the base in Alaska studies the ionosphere. In truth, the real possibilities of the installation are enormous. Climate manipulations, deep detection of underground base or deposits, silent and remote destruction of any object, and most important of all, manipulation of human behavior. If this account seems somewhat long despite my efforts to simplify, it was absolutely necessary to get to the subject I mentioned previously. Our research group is convinced that UFOs constructed by the Americans or the Russians will be used to support an AUKUS attack on the Earth of extraterrestrial origin. The media taking care of the rest, of course. The reason? Once the threats of international terrorism has dissipated, the war economies of the major powers, with the United States at the head of the pack, will need a new enemy in order to still prosper. War on Earth will be replaced by space war against an enemy from beyond. So then, gentlemen, I thank you.
And so we can now comfortably lean back and relax, because we know what's coming ahead. It's going to be a Star Wars confrontation between Russia on the one hand and its allies, which refuses to submit to someone ruling the world from Jerusalem, and therefore refuses to submit to the Anglo-American-Israeli alliance of the West.